Hello.
Dyspnoea.
Hello. Dyspnoea. That is I am going to discuss dyspnoea in brief. That is dyspnoea or the breathlessness is a symptom, subjective feeling of uncomfortable breathing. It usually results from the increased work of inhalation and exhalation, and is due to cardiopulmonary problems. The causes, main causes may be, number one is respiratory system dyspnoea, number two is cardiovascular system dyspnoea, and number three is apna dyspnoea with the normal respiratory cardiovascular systems. So first is the apna respiratory system dyspnoea. Respiratory system dyspnoea, that is it has three parts. One airway disease, number two chest wall disorders, and is number three is lung parenchyma disorders. Number one airway disease, that is for example asthma and COPD, and number second part is chest wall disorders, that is kyphoscoliosis, that is chest wall stiffness and myasthenia gravis, that is neuromuscular weakness, and then the third was lung parenchyma disorders, that is interstitial lung diseases, for example SLE, systemic lupus, SLE and ankylosing spondylitis, and ankylosing arthritis, and then second part was cardiovascular system dyspnoea, that is left heart disorders. Beloved, left heart disorders ho gaya, for example mitral valve disorders. Then second is a pulmonary vascular disorders, that is pulmonary emboli, primary pulmonary arterial hypertension and pulmonary vasculitis and pericardial diseases. That is the third part of the cardiovascular system dyspnoea, is pericardial diseases, that is constrictive pericarditis and pericardial tamponade. Then let us discuss the main third part of dyspnoea, that is dyspnoea with normal respiratory cardiovascular systems. That is for example, number one is anemia. Anemia can cause dyspnoea, especially with aggression. Then obesity may also be associated with dyspnoea due to high cardiac output, and deconditioning may also be. Then history, that is a description of the discomfort. For example, including number one, the impact of pollution will affect the dyspnoea. Number two, infection will also affect, and then environmental exposure will also affect dyspnoea. For example, orthopnea, that is the patient will be person feels breathlessness or dyspnoea while lying down. For example, in the CHF, congestive heart failure, and nocturnal dyspnoea, that is when the person is sleeping, he or she may feel breathlessness. That is called nocturnal dyspnoea. It is found in CHF and asthma. Then intermittent dyspnoea, that is for example, it is found in myocardial ischemia, MI, and asthma or pulmonary embolism. Introduction, when we feel we cannot breathe in and fear. When we feel we cannot breathe in and fear, a condition medically known as dyspnoea or shortness of breath is a symptom, health problem, and is usually heart or lung diseases. But also get temporary dyspnoea after intense workout. Dyspnoea at altitude, that is called altitude sickness. That is usually with the person who are not used to it, due to lack of oxygen at high altitudes. Usually it occurs at and above 8000 feet or above. Symptoms: patient will get headache and insomnia in altitude sickness, and the main symptom is in the dyspnea. Now I am going to discuss symptoms of the dyspnea. The main symptom is the labored breathing. It may be for a minute or two after a vigorous activity, and it is a chronic problem. One can feel as if he or she is not getting enough air into the lungs all the time, or we are suffocating, or having bouts of dyspnea, and that will cause chest tightness, or we feel a chest tightness. Shortness of breath sooner than it used to be after physical activity. We will feel shortness of breath. Sooner after physical activity than it should be. It was used to be. And breathlessness after activity they used to do without any problem in the past. And we will start to feel or experience dyspnea without any explanation. Then exercise will also usually trigger the short-term dyspnea. And at altitudes at or above 8000 feet above the ground, we feel shortness of breath due to less oxygen or thinner air and conditions treat the dyspnea as an emergency and bring about treat the conditions which bring about sudden dyspnea, sudden breathlessness. These may include heart failure, low blood pressure, pneumonia, pulmonary embolism. There is a blood clot in the pulmonary embolism. There is a blood clot in the lungs, and carbon monoxide poisoning, and stress, anxiety, and also feel sudden dyspnea. You will also feel a sudden dyspnea if a piece of food or some other object blocks our airway, and any injury harming the lung can cause rapid blood loss. And any injury which is harming the lung and causing rapid blood loss also makes the breathing difficult. And if the dyspnea is more than 4 weeks, then it is called chronic dyspnea. For example, it is found in COPD, emphysema with chronic bronchitis, and interstitial lung diseases. Number one in this chronic dyspnea is found in COPD. Then number two, interstitial lung disease. For example, now interstitial lung disease, that is scarring of the lung tissue. For example, in SLE and rheumatoid arthritis and ankylosing spondylitis, etc. And obesity and in heart diseases, asthma. Is both a chronic and a short-term emergency. And it also depends on the nature of the condition of the person and availability of the inhaler to treat or give relief to the patient conditions. That is all about the dyspnea. Thank you.